See, this is the 36.10. For the carbon steel, we have this code book. You can able to see my screen, right? The PDF. Here you
Yeah.
see, see inside the code book, if you go inside, for the size, what is the size and what is the wall thickness, the schedule, all the details we are going to get from this. This is the standard we can get it all over the world. If you are going to work for the ASME pipe, B36.10 means this is the wall thickness for the pipe. There is a schedules. We have the schedule. If you go for the 2-inch pipe, see this is a 2-inch pipe means we have the schedule 5, 10, 30, 40, 80, 160. If pipe 2-inch 160 schedule means the thickness is always 8.74. This is the world market standardization of the pipe wall thickness. There is a non-standard also is there. So that is not specified. Most probably the pipe wall thickness selection has to be taken care as per the schedule. Based on the pressure, the wall thickness calculation has to be taken care by the pressure. The formula which is available from the code book. What is the code book? The pipe wall thickness calculation for the process piping, the oil and gas piping. From which code book we are getting that wall thickness calculation formula? Anyone tell me?
B31.3.
Yes, B31.3. That is the code book which we are using to get the pipe wall thickness calculation. So this is the B31.3 code book for process piping. This, as a stress engineer, he must know what was inside this 538 pages. This is a like a Quran or Bible or a Bhagavad Gita, whatever it may be. This is the main thing which required by the piping engineer and all the formulas, definitions, everything which available in this code book, and he must know how to read this code book. In the next session, I will tell you how to read this code book and which is more important in this code. Okay. And here in this code book, we have the formula. This is the pipe wall thickness calculation formula which we are using in the oil and gas process piping. To calculate the thickness, the pressure, the dia, and SEW we have. And what is that SEW means? You see, it is a E is the quality factor, and S is the stress allowable value. The stress allowable value is the main thing the stress engineer has to know, because without knowing the stress allowables, he can't do any stress analysis. That details we are going to get it from the table A1M. That is the appendix A. We have many appendix in this code. If you see, there is a appendix in the index. So appendix A, B, C, D, E, F, like that many appendix are there in this B31.3. In this, each and everything is used by the stress engineer to do the stress analysis. I will tell one by one what is the purpose and everything. So here I mentioned that appendix A, which give the allowable stress. That is the limit. If you want to do some analysis, there is some limit we have to maintain. If you cross the limit, our system was getting failed. If you do within the limit, our system was getting passed. Like that, only the stress analysis concepts are working on. So as a stress engineer, he must know how to read this appendix A. See, this is the appendix A. If you see, based on the material and the temperature, we have the allowable values. See, these are all the materials. Different materials are mentioned. The UNX number, everything, and then temperature details for this temperature and what is the allowable values. Like that, it was mentioned. So you see how many pages are there? Nearly 100 pages are there. We have to know how to read. If A106 grade B is the material mean, for that, what is the allowable? That we have to read. A106 grade A, and this is the grade B material for the based on the temperature. So basic allowable stress for the temperature, we have the value. These are the allowables. A106 grade B means these are the allowables which we have to take care for in our system. So for each temperature, we have the allowables. So what we have to note down is that we have to mention A106 grade B, the serial number was 31. So for this 31, we have to check the temperature wise. The next sheet, we have the details. So the serial number was 31. For this 31, what is the allowable? Which was in the megapascal, the basic allowable stress for each temperature. Up to 40 degree, the minimum temperature to 40 degree and Celsius and 65 degree Celsius, 100 degree Celsius, 150, 200, like that it was going up. For that 106 grade B material, what is the allowable? That means 138 megapascal. This is the allowable limit. We have to do the stress analysis and we have to maintain less than this allowables. Like that, the stress analysis we are going to do in the Caesar. I will explain that.
I have one question in this.
Yes.
As we see earlier, the carbon steel pipe, we are using up to 427 degrees centigrade only, right?
Yes.
I am saying carbon steel, not alloy steel, right? But if we see against the 31 serial number, the temperature range is given up to 600 degrees for allowable sand. So, yes. Can you please explain a little bit more on this?
Yeah, that is the thing. Up to 427, we can go for the alloy means. Here, what is the allowables means? 427. This allowable was less than 80. And if you have to take care for that pipe, what is the flange? And the flange selection also we are taking care. The flange selection was based on the ratings. For that 106 grade B, for this we have some pressure. That is the details we are getting from this B16.5. We have to check everything, whether the flange, all the fittings, everything has to be satisfied in that or not. The pipe material, the flange material, everything has to be taken care. So here also up to is there. The rating also will be different based on the temperature. There is a limit. That means exactly as a process layout guy, you have to tell me, because that selection has to be made by the process engineers. And there is a criteria, 427 means that is the limit. That like that only as a stress engineer, I have the idea about that. Why they can't go for above 538 means that idea I don't have, because that has to be taken care from the process. Am I right? So okay. Process engineer has to answer that, because there is a limitation up to 427 only we are going to the big. But from my understanding, what I feel is that we can't take only the pipe material, the flange material, the elbows, everything we have to take in care. Whether for that process also we have to on what is the fluid, that also has to be taken care. If it's a more high corrosion fluid means, even for less temperature, even for 80 degree Celsius also, we can go for the stainless steel material. There is no criteria. Up to 427 means we have to go for carbon steel, not like that. If it's a high corrosion material, means then we can go for the stainless steel. Even as a water, just water, there is no temperature, just water, but it's a more high corrosion water or any fluid is coming means, then we go for the stainless steel. There is no limit. After 530 degrees Celsius only we go for stainless steel, not like that. And also
sorry to interrupt, my question was different. Actually, the code itself is suggesting us or giving a limitation to use up to -427 degree, right? But in the code again, they are giving allowable up to the 600 degree temperature. So that was the confusion to me, that why at one end code is specifying that carbon steel can be used up to 427 degree, and then code again giving us allowables up to 600 degree.
Yeah, that's a worst condition, right? We can't use the worst condition in our project because the fatigue analysis, everything we have to take in care. The lifelong we have to take care because the hertz are running means for that there is a more flexibility and the pipe, the stiffness, everything will be reducing. That will not be standardized. So we can't specify up to 600 we can use the material. Like that we can't predict that. Because there is a maximum up to 600 we can use, but our for the lifelong we have to take means that we can't use the material.
Okay, so understand.
That is the consideration, and even that is my understanding. So for that, everything has some limit, and the fatigue analysis we have to take in care. For 20 years, 30 years, the plant has to run means for that whether this material can withstand. If you go for the worst condition 600 and the allowable was less means, if anything happened means that will not be acceptable, right? So we have to make some limit. So that is the thing. Up to 427, we can go for cold moisture. Like some limitation we are creating. We can't go for the worst condition. Okay. So now, I mentioned here in the presentation the grouping. Here, why I written the grouping specifically means, as a stress engineer from the PMS, he has to know what is the material of the pipe and what is the flange material. And from this 16.5, this is the flange code book, here he must know how to read the grouping. Because here the flange leakage test we are going to do in CESAR. So in the CESAR, we have the flange leakage test. If you are going to do the flange leakage test for any flanges, there is the option pressure equivalent method and NC method are there. The pressure equivalent method, we have to select for this 106 grade D is the material means. For that material, based on the pressure and the temperature, we have to know what is the grouping code. So if you know the group code, see this for the rating wise, we have to select what is the group. For A106 grade B, I mentioned A105 material, it was in the group 1:1. See, A105, which was in the group 1:1. If you know this grouping, then only we can do the pressure requirement method. So if you select this 1:1 group, for that, what is the temperature and pressure details that will be come in this season? I will explain each and everything just for this flange leakage. Mr. Manoj asked how to do the flange leakage. What is the purpose? That is the reason I'm sharing here. If you see, compare this code book. This is the 1:1 grouping for A105 flange. What is the temperature and the pressure rate? So for 150 rating for this temperature, this is the details. See, most probably it will be same. For 38, it was 19.6 that was showing here. So likewise up to 538, what is the pressure? What is this pressure temperature rating? So these details is shown here. If you know what is the pipe flange material, then only we will select the exact group, and from that exact group, based on the rating and the temperature, you will get these details as an input in the CESAR. And if you know what is the cascade dia details, that will automatically come based on the material and the pipe dia. The gasket mean dia will come. So So based on this, we are doing the flange leakage test. This PQ means is a pressure equivalent method. I will explain the formulas and everything, how this equation was worked out for the flange leakage. And there is an NC method. This is based on the bolt details. I will explain in the further classes. Okay. Now again, I'll go to the presentation. Whether you can able to see my screen, the presentation slide.
Yes, yes.
So here, likewise for 106 is 1.1 means, likewise for 5L grade 60 means it's a 1.7 is a A70L3CL3. That is the flange material. And A333 grade 6 is the pipe material means for that the flange material will be a 350 graded LFT. And the grouping will be 1.1 or 1.2 if this is the flange material. These details we are getting from the PMS. Likewise, there is a different materials. Manoj, whether you use these materials in your projects, D444 is B7900?
No, sir.
Because most probably you people are working with onshore only, or offshore also your people are working offshore projects?
No, we are working in refinery downstream.
Downstream only. Okay. Okay, here these are all the materials I'm collecting from onshore, offshore, the downstream, upstream, all the projects, the reasonable materials which people are working, that only I'm listed out here. So these are all the B444 materials which we are using the fixed platforms FPSO, that means the offshore piping. So these are the materials, and just the knowledge purpose I'm sharing here. And you see for B444, this is the flange material. For that, the group code was 3.8. If you know exactly the 3.8, then only we can select in our season the 3.8. So likewise, the difference material is there. And for UD people, you have to know, understand is that, for I already mentioned, alloy means it's a A333 is the alloy material, and A312 is the stainless steel. And by seeing the name itself, we have to differentiate whether it's alloy or stainless steel. And here it's mentioned P11 and F11, and P5, F5. So P22 is a F22. From this, we can have a differentiate whether it's a pipe material or flange material. And most probably for the alloy and stainless steel, the flange material will be in A182. So you see the combination, the A182 is the name. And F11, F5, like that it was. And the grouping, the main reason we have to know is the grouping. What is the group from the B16.5? So likewise for different pipe material, different flange material, and what is the grouping? The details the stress engineer has to know. Okay, and then walls. Just small idea about the walls I'm going to share now. The different walls which we are using in our projects. The gate, globe, check, like that many walls are there. And these are the some of the walls which we are using in our projects. Globe, gate, ball, butterfly. In that, the main four or five walls I'm going to share with the images. So this is the globe wall which we are using in our projects. Most probably for the pressure drop, we are using the globe wall. Mr. Manoj, I have a small question. Here,
yep.
This wall, maybe the pupils also can explain how we are making the wall, because if like a small, for pipe like this, we have to introduce pipe walls like this, and we have to introduce the wall, a globe wall. So A to B is the, and here the flow will be like this, means how we are going to place the globe wall in the layout.
Yeah, we have to place it along the flow direction. So the B to A will be the direction.
Okay, that is a thing for the flow. What about gate?
Basically, gate wall doesn't require any in placement or in installation. There is no any specific requirement to install along the direction.
Yes.
So it's a bidirectional wall. Gate wall is a bidirectional wall.
Yes. And NRV?
NRV is a current. NRV is again of need to be installed along the flow. So in globe
yes.
wall as well as in NRV, on the body itself, flow direction will be marked, flow arrow will be marked.
Yes, so this is the basic idea about the walls, how we are going to place the thing. So under the purpose we are using is the globe walls for the draining purpose. We are using the globe wall. For draining, we have the globe walls and the drainment, and even for the pressure drop, we are using this globe wall. Likewise, this gate wall, which looks, and as Mr. Manoj said, this is a bidirectional. Both are said, if you want to make a shutdown, if you want to make a switch on off, like that, the process, if you want to close the flow suddenly, means you can go for this gate wall. And then wall walls also we are using. This also like a, sometimes if you want to make the control, means we have a throttle. We can throttle it and we can reduce the flow. And even if you want to reduce the pressure also, we can use these wall walls in some location. By making a small off way, we can open the flow and we can make it. And then control wall means in the ball wall control, in the globe wall, we have the motor and actuator. And most probably this control wall we are using in the pressure drop. That means in the vent line, if you want to reduce the pressure from 2500 rating to 150 rating, like that, if you want to go, we can use this control wall. It's like a globe wall presentation only. In that, the motor, actuator, everything will be fitted under this arrangement. This, for this, to get this control wall, we need the support. The piping team need the support from the mechanical engineers and then the instrumentation engineers, because the actuator, motor, everything has to be designed from them. Accordingly, this has to be taken care of. For that, the data sheet preparation, everything to be taken care of accordingly. So, and the check wall, just a presentation. You'll see the check wall means is a non-return wall. If the flow was coming like this, means this will be swing upward. So the flow will be going. And if the flow try to return, means it will not return back, because it will stop the flow backward. So like that only, most probably we have the thing. So in the check wall, we have the different type: swing, piston, and inlift. I have an exact image for the swing and piston. In the piston also, it's like a two-way stroke engine like that in our automobile. So you see, if the flow was coming like this, it will try to push the piston upward and the flow will be going. If the flow trying to return back, it will not, because the piston was closed, so the flow will be stopped and it will not return back. So this is automatically will going to happen inside the wall. That is the purpose this non-return wall we have. Most probably in the project, the feed line and in the end of the thing, we have this NRV. So these are all the basic layout, and this is the piping, overall piping, the equipment, the fittings, the walls and everything. And now what is missing in our project here? What is missing? In this
supports.
Layout, what is supports? Yeah, that is the scope of stress engineer. He only going to decide what is the support and what type of support it is, whether it's a shoe support or a spring or a stud or a trunnion, whatever the support. This decision making, what type of support and what is the gap for the support, everything has to be taken care by the stress engineer. So now, as stress engineers, we are going to go in detail about each and everything about this. Okay. Now I share my Caesar screen and I will explain each and everything. All the four, whether you done modeling in Caesar previously, experience about each and whether you have any idea about each and every icon and commands and tools, any one of them has worked previously or any modeling work has done?
No, sir.
Okay, right. So here I will close this and I will open from the first so far your explanation. So in your company, you people are working with the Caesar only, right? There is a different software server, Autopipe, Row, like there is there. So your people are going to work with the Caesar software. Am I right?
Yes, our reports, I mean our projects are calculated on Caesar only. Yes,
Caesar only. Okay, great. So this is Caesar. So before starting the Caesar, we have to specify the folder where we are going to keep the file. If you have any Caesar file, means see the compressor file, a picture like that, means we have to create some folder, and then in the folder the main three files has to be taken care of. I will mention what is the file. The C2 is the folder means here the Caesar file. So CFG, fill, and C2. These are the three. So here that CFG and fill are the supporting documents, and point C2 is the our Caesar file. So if you are going to do any analysis in the folder, these two things has to be keep always, the CFG and the fill. Based on the company which you are going to work, the units, everything has to be taken care accordingly, and this has to be make this Caesar file. I will tell how I will open that file, how it will works. And this is a Caesar icon. If you open this, so this is the page will open. Here we have the configuration editor. If you open this one, what are the configuration setup which we have to keep? You can see here what is the thing. See, this is a friction. These are all the default value. We are not going to change anything. The content which we have to change is that, see the unit file name dot fill. For each project there is a different, some company will work with the pressure in bar, some company will work with the kilopascal, some with work with the newton per mm square for stress, some with megapascal they will work for the stress, some work with Fahrenheit, and some will work with the Celsius. Like that, some different units are there. For project wise, what is the unit that has to be defined, and this fill file will be created from the senior engineer, and they will provide to us, and we have to work. And if, before starting the thing, we have to check what is the unit file which we are using. So that has to be dropped down here. This is the default, and for our project wise, I mentioned SGSG is the project which I created, and that has to be taken care here. So if you are creating any new file, any name, what is the units which we are going to consider, that will be listed out here. For the force, Newton, for the temperature, Celsius, for pressure, bar, for elastic modulus, the kilopascal, like that, each and everything was listed out here for our reference. you have to check whether everything was okay or not. If that was wrong, we can make the changes also. So this is the screen will be open. If you see, this is the classic piping input. As a stress engineer, we have to fill this to do the modeling. Let's start. Before we do the modeling, I will make one rough sketch. Then only we are going to try to model. So this is the routing. Here some flanges we can add. Some wall. We can add some reducer. Small routing like this. Here, three different equipments are going to connect to this flange. Now, this routing I am going to model in CZone. And here, the pipe size, let's consider this as a 4-inch pipe. With the schedule 80 or something. Let's go for the max. How much it's grade B. Some temperature we can go at 150 degrees Celsius and a design temperature. Max and the minimum was minus 10 degrees Celsius, like that. And pressure, design pressure, you can go for some 3 bar or something. So like that we can consider, and after the reducer it becomes some 2-inch schedule 80. Like that we can consider this routing. So now I'm going to model this. Here the first thing, we have the flanges. For flanges, we have to check what is the flange. It's a weld neck flange. I mentioned 4-inch, and we have the Pipe Pro database. In this Pipe Pro data, we have the details. All the standardized details that we are having in the Pipe Pro data. For the 4-inch, 150 rating, and is a riser, rise placed flange, and schedule 80. For that, the length was 77, and the weight of the flange has to be taken care. The flange weight with the bolt we have to consider. That means 7.59 plus 1.59 plus 1.59. This was in kg. I want to convert it to newton. How much we have to multiply? Convert kg into newton. Anyone? Yes, into 9.81. That means this is our weight of the flange for 4-inch flange. So now I'm going to explain each and everything. Here you see, there is a first thing we have from and to. What is that from and to means? For each and everything, there will be a start and the end. So let's consider this will be the starting portion 10, and for this flange there is a 2 space, and here like 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, like that. That means for flange there is a 2 face will be there. So one side will be the 10 means another side will be the 20. For this pipe portion, this is the 20 means this is the 30. So that is the numbering as identity, as a naming. For each and everything, we are giving some number as an identity. So for that, these things we have to know. And this is the identity not only for the pipe fittings, for even the supports. If we have some press support here, means what is the node number? If this is a 35, is the node number, means that is the reference. What is the load? Support load at the node 35, like that we can check it and we can provide this load to the civil department. So that means this is numbering as is the main identity, and that is the presentation was shown here. So from and to means is the identity, and here dx, dy, dz means is the direction and axis of the pipe. And you see we have the axis, that XYZ axis are there, and here there is a, in the environment we have the special execution parameter. If you open this, we can specify what is the north direction. If Y is vertical, and if you want to make the minus X as the north means, we can make it. And these things and all, always make, if you are working with the greenfield project, no need to switch on this liberal. Always make it a switch off. And if you are working any onshore or refinery projects, means the seismic condition, that means the earthquake coming means, then this uniform load G has to be switched on. These settings has to be taken care. And then if your ambient temperature, what is the ambient temperature in your location? 21 or 26? For quite, what is the ambient?
30.
Okay, so that details we have to specify here. And this, if you are working with the FRP piping, then you can edit this one, otherwise no need to touch these details. And if you're working for offshore FPSO project means, then in that offshore projects Z will be vertical. So if the Z means, we can switch on this, otherwise no need to switch on. So here in this special execution parameter, we have to use this. And if you are working with the Bourdon effect, go for this, otherwise no need to touch this one. So uniform load you have to switch on, and the ambient temperature we can specify here, and what is the north direction, that's it, and no need to touch anything. That is the default settings. Make it okay. Now you see the north will be changed, the minus X direction.
Excuse me sir, sorry to interrupt you, what is Bourdon effect? That terms I come across first time, Bourdon effect.
Based on that movement, the translational and rotational, like that the movements are there. The pipe, every pipe have some based on the direction, translational and rotational, like that is the right. So that movements we have to take in care. For pipe means along the axis, that lateral axis and the vertical axis. These are all the translational movement, and for each and everything if you have the rotational movement. For that, the Bourdon effect, if you want to know the definition, exact definition, see, this is exact definition. The internal pressure causes unbalanced stress force tending to open up the elbow, depend on its stiffness and surrounding constraints. These forces tending to cause ovalization of the cross section and causing the tendency of the pipe bend to open up, other term is a Bourdon effect. This is, if the client is requested, we can switch on this, otherwise no need to touch this. Okay, it's a unbalanced thrust force which acting in the pipe.
Yeah,
that based on the flow, based on the flow that will be decided what type of fluid and what based on the flow whether what is the pressure whether it's a balanced or unbalanced well because of this pressure whether any thrust force is creating or not then based on that we can go if you are working with any upstream projects sometimes this Bowden effect we are using because in that upstream project only the pressure will be unbearable nearly 400 300 pressure will be there 300 bar like that so unbalanced pressure will be there under that the thrust force will be greater that is the thing based on the project most probably I think the downstream it won't use actually maybe in the offshore projects the Bowden effect will come okay now
yeah
let's say yeah right so now we got some thing is that the directional here from and to means this is the identity for each and everything and dx dy dz see here now we are going to model the flange this is the 4 inch schedule 80 flange and for that we got the length is 77 and the weight was nearly some 90 newton so how I'm going to model this direction let's consider the direction so like this means now our pipe was moving in the z direction so here in the z and that means our pipe was modeled like this so that means we have to model the pipe in the minus z right the minus z we have to start modeling so that means here the dz is that minus 77 amount we have to mention and the weight we have to mention see there is the bend reducer like there is the here this is the rigid in this portion we have to mention the weight and what is the pipe dia that is 4 inch and schedule 80 in the schedule 80 as per this 36.10 the code book previously I shared 36.10 in that for schedule 80 4 inch pipe what is the thickness in mm that was shown automatically and we have to select the material here in this material from the drop down we can select the different materials are there here 106 grade B is the material I chose so now here the temperature we have to mention so 150 degree Celsius and minus 10 and let's consider the operating temperature as some 80 or something is there means the design temperature I mentioned some operating temperature will be some 80 degree Celsius or something means that has to be taken care so here 80 degree Celsius and pressure I mentioned 3 bar and for hydro pressure how we can calculate from the design pressure how we can calculate the hydro pressure from the design pressure anyone can have idea how many times we can make the
1.5 times but what I know that recently some code has some changes in that by default we cannot go with the 1.5 times is it true
yes so some projects based on this flange rating we are selecting the pressure as per V16.5 we see this is in the flange ratings and all the thing is that so for the max what the temperature what is the maximum pressure the details based on the rating these details only we will consider in the ratings for this 1.5 instead of what I'm trying to say is that for this temperature for this 105 if our rating is 150 for 150 is the 15.8 is a maximum design pressure means for this make it as a 1.5 and we are using this value
so you mean to say that if I calculate it I consider 1.5 times then it should not cross 15.8 bar right this is what you are saying
yes
okay
So like that we have to consider, and here we will go for the default which from previously we are working on. That means so 1.5 times of the TP. So that's it. So now once based on the temperature, if you select the material here, this allowables details will be coming. And what is the code book? We are working for 31.3, we have to select that code book, and here we are getting the SH value and the SC value. How we are getting this value means, that's only I told you previously, from the 31.3 code book we are getting this. From the 31.3, the process piping code book, we have the allowable value. So I select the A106 grade B material. So 31 is the serial number, and here the minimum yield strength, tensile, minimum temperature, maximum temperature, everything was mentioned. So here for 106 grade B, the next sheet, our temperature was 150. So for 150, the allowable stress, it was for 31 is a 130 megapascal. Okay, this value was defined in the CSO. See, this was in some kilopascal. So that is the reason 1000 was multiplied, and so the value has become 13789. So based on the temperature, this value will be different. So here in the code book, if you see, after 250 or 300, this become 132. Up to 200 degrees Celsius, there is no change in the allowable. It was default 138 only. After 250, it was reducing. The allowables was reducing. So we can check in CSER also. If I mention for 300, the allowable was changing. If I go for 650, see, it was not showing the any allowables, because for this material there is no allowable for 650. So what temperature you are specifying, based on this, this allowable will be defined. So from where we are getting this reference means, from the code book B31.3, the table A1, the appendix A, we have the basic allowable stress. Here it's mentioned SC and SH. Any idea what is SC and SH? What represent C and H? Any idea? C means what? H means what? Any idea? Anyone?
I think C is for cold condition and H is for all hot condition.
Yes, you are right. So that means the temperature was increasing, that is the hot condition. And SC means based on the ambient, that will be considered here. So we already feed that ambient, it was 30. So for here, as per the code book, from the minimum to up to 40, it was 138 only. So that's the reason for the ambient 30 degrees Celsius also, it was 137 only. So based on the ambient temperature, it was fed here, and based on the temperature which we are feeding, these allowables are fed coming in, and the yield strength value which we are getting also here. So the for the material, what is the yield strength? Minimum yield strength. This is 241. For 31, it's a 241 is the yield strength megapascal. That only was showing here. So 241 kilopascal. Okay. So these details we are getting from the code book. If you change the code accordingly, this allowables also will be changed. Now we are working with the process piping only. For the 31.3 is the code book. For that, we are getting the allowables like this. So this is the first sheet which we are filling up. So here mostly we will fill all the details, from what is the start node, end node for the flange, and what is the direction and what is the axis for the pipe or flange, and what is the dia thickness, and if this is have some corrosion, means that corrosion details we have to mention. And if so, what is the fluid? Let's consider, so water means water have 1000 kg per meter cube, means that fluid density we have to mention. That's it. So these are the details. And if any insulation is there, means we can mention what is the insulation thickness and what is the insulation material. What is the mineral, say calcium silicate or mineral wool, that will be from the PMS. We can get these details and we can figure it out. Now for this 150, I'm not going to consider any insulation. And if any refractory thickness cladding is there, means we can mention this. Otherwise, no need to mention. Make it as plan. Now I'm going to continue the piping. Here from 20 to 30, let's consider this as a some 5 meter pipe. 5 meter pipe. We have some dimension. Okay, let's start modeling here. So here, once this sheet was filled up, there is the option. Continue here. So we have the previous first element, the previous next last element, like that, like a remote option. We have these options, and we have the undo option also. Is that this is a navigation tool. This navigation tool we can use. So this, click on this continue, and the shortcut key also is there. What is the shortcut key? Means Alt plus C is the shortcut key to go for the next element. If you click this, the next chart will be prepared. You see there is an increment in the node number. Previously it was 10 and 20. Now it's become 20 and 30, the continuation. Now I'm going to model the pipe. In the Z direction, I mentioned 5 meter. So like this, it was modeled. Okay. So now I have a T connection here. So some T connection is there. So here I am going to specify what is the T connection. So at this point, the node number was 30. So here, shift is the T connection. Just click this, what type of T it is. And here, let's consider it's a 4x4 T only. There is no change in size. So that means it's a welding T connection. Here I can mention what is the welding. If a reinforced T, we can mention it's reinforced or unreinforced, is a weldolet or a socket, whatever it may be, that we can mention. For the equality, it is a welding. We have to mention as a welding. And we have to continue the model. And another 5 meter it was running. Now we need to make the elbow. So as per the routing, we need an elbow here. So click on this bend. There is an option called bend. If you click on this, what is the bend radius? Here is a long radius, a short radius, the details we have. If you're working for a pump pipeline projects and all, 3D, 5D bend will be there. If you want, we can select here and the details, and just again click continue. And in the X direction, we have to model the pipe. Now we have to model the pipe in the X direction like this. So in the X direction, another 5 meters. We model like this. So the bend, the fillet was formed. Okay, now how we are going to model is that we are going to continue from this flange to this flange, up to this flange we are going to model. Then we will start this T connection. So the routing has to be completed fully, then we will go for the next connection. So from this point, we are going to introduce some flange, because the valve is there, means valve before and after, there is one flanges will be there. That flange and valve has to be taken care. So now again the 4-inch flange we are going to model, that was 77, and weight 90 newton has to be taken care of, the flange. Now the wall, let's consider some globe. Okay, some gate wall or something means for that 4-inch wall, schedule class 150 rating. You can go, if it's a gate wall means, so 190 is the length and the weight was 28 kg. Sorry, for 4-inch, it's a 229 and the weight was 52 kg that we have to model here. Alt C continue and 229, and then the weight we have to consider the weight. That was 52 kg. So 52 into 9.81. Here also we do the calculation. So 52 into 9.81. We can get the weight in Newton. Again, we have to model the flange and the weight. Again, continue the piping. Elbow. If the pipe was moving in the upward direction, we have to mention here the upward direction. So the direction based on the axis. Whether people can understand how I am modeling, it's clear, right?
Yes.
So now the one thing we have to note down is that the bend here, I switch on the bend. If you see here, I switch on, this is the node number. Here the starting node was 80 and this one was 90, and this pipe that end was 100. I switch on the node 90, 80 and 90. This is the first element and this is the second element. If I delete this bend, see there is no fillet was formed. Okay, so here if I want to switch on the bend, there is a two element. I can't switch on from the second element. If I want to make a bend, I can't switch on at this location. It won't create the bend. Because in the reverse manner, the bend will not create. So always the first element has to switch on, and that in that only the bend has to be switched on. Then only the fillet will be formed. You can understand? There's a two element is that means if you want to create a fillet, always switch on the bend in the first element, not in the second element. So in the first element, we have to switch on accordingly, the fittings will be formed. In the second element, we can't make the thing. So that is the criteria we have to note on while creating the bend. And then again, from this location, I created one bend and continue, and in the some x direction, some 2500. Now it's going up. Sorry, the z direction of the pipe was coming like this means. Here I'm going to introduce some reducer. So what is the reducer length? Is a concentric reducer 4 by 2 means for the schedule 80. So 102 is the length. So that has to be specified here. That reducer, and you have to switch on here reducer. And what is the dia? So 2-inch schedule 80. That has to be mentioned. See, this is a concentric reducer. If you are going to model the eccentric reducer, means the eccentric reducer have some offset value. Right, the eccentric reducer, some offset value is there. This offset value has to be mentioned. In which axis we have to mention the offset value? Any idea? Here, instead of concentric, I am going to model as a eccentric. This offset value 27, I have to mention. Whether in the dx or dy, I have to mention. Anyone tell me?
Vertical direction, dy direction.
In the minus or